population.
All right, go on over there now and wave, and yeah, I'll take.
Hurry, hurry, hurry.
That says on it?
That's Latin.
Our wonderful travel van.
We've alerted the
Isn't
Swiss
nice
government that we'll be loose.
This is where we're going. Everywhere. Somewhere. I don't know.
For a 3-hour tour.
This is Bern, Switzerland.
Zero yen. But your penthouse suite.
Where the bother is.
The famous bears of Bern. The cathedral here in Bern. We can't speak German, so I don't know too much history about it. Shows on the postcard he's being one of the pretty saints. This is in Greenwald. It's all the way up from Interlaken. We're debating, trying to determine whether you want to catch a train to the top of the mountain or not. It's about as far as you can drive.
Was that a glider up there or something?
Right now it's probably what, about 70 degrees out here.
Yeah. Blue, look at the blueness of the blue or green tint to the ice.
The waterfall with the melting ice.
It's coming out pretty good too.
Very kind of teens in the vehicle.
Yeah, just a second.
You follow that, see that waterfall, and you follow it all the way up.
Oh, I see, a couple.
It's several falls. Let's see, crystal clear.
Thank you.
getting further right down at the bottom of the glacier right now. Gonna walk up into it. It still feels like it's about 60, high 60s or 70 degrees. Feet from where the last picture was taken. Snow has already gotten real deep. A cave there in the glacier.
All right, go on over there now and wave, and
yeah,
I'll take your picture.
In the cave?
Yeah.
Right.
Huh. Look at, the guy's got right over there. I guess you can.
This is just another view from a different angle, just about as high as we could probably get. Little building we saw from down below is right up there. This isn't as easy as it was going up.
Yeah, going up you just took two steps forward and one back. This one you have to protect yourself.
Rooms, we've got four rooms. It's fairly nice, but this is right outside off of my patio. The patio right here is where the other guys are on. There's Arnold. And they furnished breakfast, and this is the mountains we've been looking at. So it's a park our van right down below us. The rooms are sort of quaint. This is a little larger room. This is a newer hotel than what the front one is that they're staying in. So the rooms are just a little bit nicer. Here's the front entrance to the Alta Post. Where we're staying, this is, most of the hotels are closed around here now. This one here has only got a few rooms open. Gentlemen getting an early morning start. This is Sunday morning. One of the many waterfalls around. It's melting snow coming off the mountains. This is a ski lift right behind where we're staying. It's obviously non-operational now. through the excursion to a young crow up on top of the mountain. Arnold and I are staying down here.
There's only two cars. Like I said, they can do it. They don't have to worry about the ski. You don't see anybody just kind of easing over.
Everybody's scurrying on to get on the car.
We got up here on a single lane road with about 1 foot of shoulder, and Larry's pointing that way going, look at the view from here. We could have been part of the view.
There's these signs that says something about a car with a cross on it. We don't know what that means. So because we don't know what it means, we're going to keep driving up.
I think it means red cars are forbidden.
This is looking back onto Rindewall. Don't know if you can hear it in the camera, but someone's shooting down there.
They haven't got close enough for us to move yet.
We got our red car, so we're not worried that they're going to shoot at us and mistake us for a deer.
And there's a wonderful atmosphere here as the farmers ready themselves for spring, and they have done all the cleaning of their animal sheds.
Yeah, well, you ought to enjoy the aroma. We can't quite get this on film, but it's they've definitely taken all the winter pilings and have spread them out to make the yards green. We're still driving up. We're several thousand feet higher than we were earlier when we stopped. And the beautiful waterfall. A lot of snow up here now. We don't see any other vehicles up here, so we're not quite sure we're supposed to be up this high.
Behind this tree here, and it'll show how high we are with the mountain. And
first, right here on the side of the hill. Nothing on us up here. We got a helicopter coming over. We think maybe he's coming to tell us we're in the wrong place.
There must be another glacier up on top there above the railway. Look at how it piles up in there. Started out in the city of Grindelwald and dropped off half or most of the group to take a train ride up into this portion of the hills here. Being much more brave, we decided to take the tour with just some little turns up and down with a change of elevation of only 1,000 or so meters. We're now up at the top of this hill called Busalp or Busalp. And this area appears to be closed for all skiing and all vacationers. Restaurant is closed. Very, very beautiful sight in the area. Larry's now looking at some of the ski runs, and we met a couple local people that had gone off and
skied some of the way this morning. Looked like they had a four-wheel drive vehicle to get up in some of the snow. That's all we went up is about 1,000 meters, 3,000 feet. You want to take a look at the top of the...
While ago. Down at the bottom. I'm about to run out of battery, so I'm going to stop this for now. Well, it's about as high as we're going to go.
End of the road.
Here's where somebody, it's interesting because we were wondering how they got wood up here. It looks like they cut the wood themselves. There's the logs and this is the scraps from where they cut it. Made their own wood. Here's a fairly new building that they just put up.
Base up there?
Yeah, I think that's where we were. We're back down on the ground looking up now, trying to figure out where we were a while ago when we took all those other movies. We just know it's a long ways up.
Could it
where
be,
we're standing right
could
now.
Could it be
is
that area to the right? I thought.
No, because we were near where that broken rock was.
Where that rock face is?
Yeah, because that's a...
Okay. Yeah?
We were up right near that area right there. And somewhere right up in there is a cabin. I don't know if I can see it. I can't see it through this lens.
It's up where it was all up in the snow area there, though, that's for sure.
Luzerne is on this big lake. Yeah. One of the local restaurants.
Another on many of yours, right?
Right.
It's like triple or one.
Get that picture, man. See if that doesn't help you.
This second.
See if
some of the locals have just got through using the needles.
Zwischen die Sachen singen die in 200 Stroh und 200 Sekunden. picture of Luzerne taken up from a wall of the tower.
Aktuelle Meldung zum Thema Umwelt von Walter C. Frisch, der sich live vor Örtchen befindet.
Ausgezeichnete Umweltverträglichkeit wurde den WC Frisch-Reinigern jetzt von der Henkel Umweltforschung beschafft. Denn alle Wirkstoffe sind vollständig abbaubar. Ob mit Zitronensäure oder Apfelessig.
WC Frisch mit voller Kraft umweltverträglich reinigen.
Kommst du noch mit auf eine Ölsardine?
Fang frische Ölsardinen von Apple. Es empfiehlt sich immer, etwas Apple im Haus zu haben.
So ist das eben mit Pommes, mit diesem neuen bärenstarken Kartoffelsnack. Man macht sich eine Tüte auf, freut sich auf viele knusprige Erlebnisse. Und dann? Ja, dann? Dann ist man froh, dass man noch eine Tüte hat.
Pommes von Wolf Bergstraße. Der erste Wolf, der backen kann.
Grauschimmel haben wir gesucht. Naja, Oliver, so ein bisschen in die Nähe sind Sie gekommen, aber man kann nichts machen, ne? Es muss Klick machen in der Bonusrunde. Herzlichen Dank fürs Mitmachen. Auch der Jackie und dem Thomas. Herzlichen Dank für den Besuch hier im Studio. Herzlichen Dank fürs Zusehen. Wir sehen uns morgen wieder. Ciao.
Wenn Sie, liebe Zuschauer, sich beim CD...
Herr Kalle, abfliegend nach Mailand, wird umgehend zum Ausgang 29 gebeten. Herr Kahler, bitte. Mr. Kahler, leaving for Milano, is requested to proceed immediately to gate 29.